right, the editor of an evangelical Christian magazine is defending an op-ed in which he called for President Trump to be impeached. The editor of Christianity Today, Mark Golley, has been blasted by the president as being far left. And today, Golley explained the reasons he decided to criticize the president.
The point of my argument is not to judge him as a person in the eyes of God. That's not my job. But to judge his public moral character and ask, has he gone so far that the evangelical constituency that we represent, can we in good conscience do the trade-off anymore? He right. gives us what we need on pro-life, but he's got this bad character.
In the Washington Post, columnist Nancy French also defended Golley's editorial, writing in part, a Christianity dependent on Trump is a weak faith indeed, adding, Christianity has endured and flourished for two millennia, often against unimaginable persecution. When a faith is sustained by God, it has no need to compromise its witness in service of an adulterous, mendacious reality TV star. And with me now, Nancy French, the opinion writer for the Washington Post, who wrote that editorial in which I just borrowed some of that language. So Nancy, good to see you. Why is it important for you to write this, to defend Mark Golley?
Well, I think it just shows that Christians are finally able and ready to declare that the tenets that we've been proposing for the past two decades are not partisan, but they're actually deeply held beliefs. Golley's essay was not an attack on the president as much as it was just a basic defense of Christian principles and morals.
And so for evangelicals who perhaps don't support this president, has this editorial, Golley's editorial, made any type of impact on it in your view?
You know, it's hard to tell. I think what it says is that there is a remnant, a part of the Christian church that will not tolerate any longer what Donald Trump has been doing. I think a lot of us held our noses and voted for President Trump. I didn't. But a lot of people did, hoping that they could forgive what he did in the past and see a better person, that he would surround himself with good people who would do the right thing. He has done a couple of great things, but he has disappointed us repeatedly, and I think that this part of the church is uncomfortable.
But he still has strong, particularly white evangelical support, does he not?
He does, and it's very disappointing to me personally as a Presbyterian. Mm-hmm. Well, if you look at the church as a whole, you're right. Trump has a lot of support with white evangelicals, but if you encompass all of the church, there's a lot more discomfort about supporting him than the polls look.
Hmm. And what are people saying?
Well, you know, they're just saying that they're voting for the lesser of two evils, that there's not a good option on the Democratic side, which I completely have sympathy for. But the thing is, you have to, at some point, quit defending the indefensible. It's one thing to say, I will support President Trump, and I will support his good policies. But President Trump demands that you're obsequious. He demands your full support. He doesn't just allow you to support policy A or policy B while condemning his actions. And that's what's so disappointing, is that members of the church, maybe people who aren't as serious about their mm-hmm. theology, will defend the indefensible mm-hmm. and call evil good.
But are you and Mark Golley kind of anomalies that you're willing to speak out publicly against the president when largely, and you just said it yourself, particularly white evangelicals, do support the president, even though they may grimace at a few things when it comes to, you know, their vote, he still has it.
You're exactly right. But the good thing about Christianity, the good news about it, is that it does not operate by consensus. So it has flourished for thousands of years independently of what the world has thought. And so currently, right now, there's a remnant of people who have decided that President Trump has gone too far and that we are no longer willing to make compromises for this president.
Nancy French, thank you so much. Have a great holiday. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.